The following portion of Good Day PA is sponsored by Penn State Cancer Institute.
A cancer diagnosis is often unexpected.
And that was the case for a Mechanicsburg nurse who has taken care of cancer patients for 30 years. Susan Court is here to explain.
That's right. Doris Shank is a two-time cancer survivor and now has an even deeper understanding of what her patients go through to survive and thrive. She is a big advocate for clinical trials and a caring support team, both things she credits for her positive outcomes. Here's Doris's story.
Life hasn't been easy for 61-year-old Doris Shank. 8 years ago, she lost her best friend.
In 2016, my husband was diagnosed with stage 4 lung cancer. What that means is it started in his lung and it spread to his bones, his brain, and his liver. I put my husband in the hospital on February 13th of 2016, and he died on February 21st.
Later that year, Doris was diagnosed with cancer too.
I was diagnosed with endometrial cancer. And the first thing I thought of was, how am I going to tell my husband? Because I still was grieving for my husband. But that cancer was early and was cured by surgery.
2 years ago, more devastating news.
My sister and I are lined up for our mammograms. Now, my sister and I have always done everything together. My sister's was fine and mine wasn't. They found two lesions in my right breast and they were biopsied and I had cancer.
Doris was terrified.
The first thing I thought of was I was going to die. And I know that's what goes through every cancer patient when they first hear those words, you have cancer.
As administrative director of the clinical trials office at Penn State Cancer Institute, Doris knew what was next: chemotherapy, surgery, radiation, and some treatments that came out of clinical trials.
Clinical trials give people hope because it gives them the opportunity to help themselves, but more importantly, to help those who are going to come after them. And that's the key.
Hope that resounded when Doris rang the bell. It signified the end of her cancer treatment.
My team was down there and they had noisemakers and they had confetti and they celebrated with me because they took the journey with me. They chose to take this journey with me.
Doris doesn't know what she would have done without family, friends, and coworkers at the Penn State Cancer Institute Care Center. Especially Dr. Michael Hayes, who was with her every step of the way.
It's been amazing to see the ways in which she's been challenged physically, emotionally, spiritually, and her willingness to accept help, which can be really tough.
Penn State Cancer Institute has a unique care center that helped Doris and many others along their journey, treating not only the cancer, but the entire patient.
The care center is really about the rest of it, the person, their loved ones, and making sure that the care we deliver is not just about the medication or surgery or radiation, in the process, making sure that we see the person, understand their unique situations, and do our level best to provide the supports that they need over the course of their treatment, as well as beyond into the rest of their lives.
It's one of the most unique places and one of the most wonderful places I have ever seen. I have taken advantage of the care that has been given in the care center. And it has helped me tremendously.
The Penn State Cancer Institute Care Center offers genetics and nutritional counseling, a yearly retreat for patients and caregivers, a creative writing workshop, an arts program, and lots of hope.
Some of our patients describe how the experience here has helped them to recognize cancer gifts. Strange to think of cancer as gifts, but to recognize in the course of their journey that they've discovered gifts that they wouldn't have had otherwise. I think the care center is a place where we infuse hope.
Doris embraced the hope, and it helped her through her cancer journey.
I think what got me through this was the support that I have here at work. The men and women that I work with are devoted to clinical trials and devoted to finding a cure for cancer or finding a better, safer, less toxic way to treat cancer.
Support and dedication that keeps Doris committed to helping others.
First and foremost, I am a nurse, and it is my job as a nurse to help others. Doesn't matter how I do it, but it's my job and a gift as a nurse to help others.
Doris says that the future of all cancer treatment is so bright, thanks in great part to targeted drug therapies as a result of clinical trials. She also stresses the importance of screening for cancer, because the earlier you catch it, the more likely you are to survive. Back to you, Amy.
Thank you so much, Susan. Now joining us is Doris Shank, cancer survivor and administrative director in the clinical trials office at Penn State Cancer Institute. Also, Dr. Karen Kim, dean of Penn State College of Medicine. Doris, what a great story. Loved hearing your story. You have such a great attitude. Tell us about how your job is helping to educate other people about the importance of clinical trials.
Every drug that has been used to treat cancer, to treat diabetes, to treat any disease has been studied under a clinical trial, period.
So, hey, you gotta participate, right? Mm-hmm. To get to that. So Dr. Kim, you must be proud of Doris, of course, and all her accomplishments and incredible spirit. And we are fortunate to have, you know, Penn State College of Medicine and this amazing research happening right here in our backyard. Talk about the importance of that, these clinical trials.
Yeah, clinical trials, as Doris said, first of all, thank you for sharing your story and for working with us. Clinical trials are really essential to get people over the hump when it comes to cancer. You know, it's sort of these life-saving, sometimes last-minute, last option for some patients and families to really be able to beat this disease and move into a survivorship mode. So it's essential that we have research that allows us to study new therapies, and then we work with families and patients to be able to test them.
I understand you're very passionate about making sure all patients have access to cancer care, clinical trials, especially those who may be more vulnerable to certain types of cancer. Talk about that.
Yeah, you know, I think cancer health equity is, you know, making sure that everyone has equal access to the same therapies. Sometimes we don't see that happening. And where I'm very interested in is thinking about rural populations who are very vulnerable to kind of later stage cancers. And so I think a big push for us right now is to make sure that all populations, including rural populations, have access to clinical trials. And I know at the Penn State Cancer Institute, about 20% of the patients that we see are entering into clinical trials are actually from rural communities. So I think we're making a difference.
That's great. I love what you said. Like, you're like, first and foremost, I am a nurse. My job is to take care of people. And I mean, you're doing that more and more just by being here today. Like, how does it feel for you as a cancer survivor to know you're, you know, turning that into good, you're helping other people?
When my husband was diagnosed with cancer, he said that you have to play the cards that you're given, and there is always good that comes out of anything. The good that came out of my diagnosis of cancer is that I can be vocal for men and women who have breast cancer to get early treatment, to get mammograms. If they find a lump, get to your physician, because it most probably won't go away. I want to be an advocate to help allay the fears, because I will tell you, it is the having someone say you have cancer is the most scariest thing any individual could ever hear.
Oh my gosh, of course, yes. And Dr. Kim, again, we're talking about survivorship today, featuring cancer survivors who are now helping others diagnosed with cancer. And I understand that, you know, you have a personal connection with cancer. Tell me about that.
Yeah, my mother died about 29 years ago from a cancer which, if she were alive today, because of research and new therapies, she'd be sitting on this couch next to us. So that's what research and innovation does. That's what these clinical trials are doing. They're allowing families to live and share stories like Doris. And it's one of the big drivers for why I do the work that I do.
And obviously, this is just going to keep going. So what do you think the future holds in terms of research and treatment for cancer?
I'm hoping through research and discovery, we won't need to be having these discussions, that everyone in the world, in the nation, in Pennsylvania, never needs to have those scary conversations about you have cancer, because we have therapies and treatment and early detection to prevent it.
Well, I thank you both for sharing. It's been lovely talking with you. So thank you so much for being on the show today. Thank you so much for sharing your story with so many people. We thank both of them for being with us this morning. For more information about Penn State Health clinical trials, visit studyfinder.psu.edu.